Here we go. A player smash. Ooh. Okay, just starting off with a new intro. Well, sort of that.
Hello, this is
Hi, Sakurai.
From Sora Limited, and this is the final Nintendo Direct before the launch of Super Smash Bros. Ultimate.
Yep.
So far, we've confirmed 72 fighters.
72 fighters.
If you count Pokemon Trainer as 3. Our entire team has worked really hard. With this Nintendo Direct, we'll have revealed every fighter you can find in the game.
Every fighter.
Okay, let's do this.
Let's do it. Starting off with it. Boxing area? Yo, it's fucking Ken! Yo! It's absolute Ken. Oh my god. Yep. Ken turns up the heat. I'm glad we're getting Ken. Because everybody was expecting Ken was going to be happening. Sure. Hadouken! Wait, what is that? What was that? Yeah, we got that. Ooh! Ooh!
That's right.
What is that? Wait. Incineroar! Oh, yes! Yes!
So, you want to fight fire with fire, huh?
That's where you get a wrestling into today. Because Incineroar isn't a wrestler. But holy shit, yes! Finally, we get a Sun and Moon, It looks so good. The model is so good from Incineroar. Oh my goodness. Oh yes. Dark Lorette. KO. Yeah, Villager, K-Wool, and Bowser Jr. Ken? Incineroar? Awesome. I believe there's probably a few more.
Hailing from the Street Fighter series, Ryu's rival Ken joins as an Echo Fighter.
Yeah!
In his original game, Ken could be considered Ryu's Echo Fighter.
Yep.
Though perhaps you could say Luigi is the original Echo Fighter.
So
back to Ken.
Yeah, back to Ken.
Ken has been distinguished from Ryu over the years. That the Ken you
yep, since Street Fighter 1?
Street Fighter 2 Turbo.
But he's changed in Street Fighter 2.
His heavy Shoryuken turns up the heat.
Shoryuken!
The shape of his Hadouken is different too. And his Tatsumaki Senpūkeku strikes a
Tatsumaki Senpūkeku. I don't know what in the my vocabulary.
Focus attack.
Sweet.
We've included lots of Ken's signature moves, such as his famous kicks, which change based on your command inputs.
Nice.
He's a bit faster than Ryu, and we've also incorporated other tweaks from recent titles.
Nice.
Like Ryu, he has 2 final smashes.
Yep, just like Ryu.
The spinning uppercut, Shinryuken. We've made it look flashy, as it is in the Versus series. Execute a final smash near an opponent, and you'll instead perform a Shippu Jinraigeki.
Oof. Incineroar. Let's talk about Incineroar.
New challenger, Incineroar. It may be a Pokemon, but it mainly uses pro wrestling moves, and as such, its throws are a bit more powerful. Like a true pro wrestler, when one of its attacks is successful, it'll pose for the audience. Luckily, you can cancel out of these poses.
I love this Sun and Moon music coming in the background.
Its neutral special is called Darkest Lariat. It was in
Darkest Lariat, yep.
In the Pokemon Sun and Pokemon Moon games. Perhaps it's something of a red cyclone.
Its signature move
is Cross Chop.
Cross Chop.
You'll leap up and come rocketing back down.
You go up and then in an aerial So you go in an aerial in an aerial move.
For its side special, Incineroar makes opponents run
for
a dash and grab. When they bounce back your way, press the button at just the right
Ooh.
Moment. If you're too early, you'll do a back body drop. Wait
back
too
body?
Long and you'll fail.
What?
Nail the timing and you'll pull off a powerful lariat.
Ooh!
Its down special is Revenge.
Is that a counter? Yep, it's a counter.
Passion comes to the surface, powering up its next attack. That's Incineroar's idea of a counterattack. And its final smash? Max Malicious Moonsault. It's even faster and fiercer than the Z-move it's based on.
Wow.
We finally revealed all of the fighters you'll find in the game. This is the initial fighter select screen. There aren't very many at first, but it is the same amount as the original Nintendo 64 game.
Yep.
And once you've unlocked them all, it'll look like this. It may seem hard to guess where each one's located, but they're sorted by number in the order they joined the series. I hope you'll enjoy battling with all 74 fighters on the roster.
74 fighters, Jesus. Amiibo? Yep. That's really good quality of Inkling. Really? That's a good quality. Wow. Wolf, yep. December 7th, yep. I'm maybe getting one of those,
You may recall that we're creating Amiibo in parallel with the game.
Ooh.
Here's a look at the
Ooh. Give me an icon's clash.
The collectible trophies wouldn't be a great fit for this game. Honestly, they were really difficult to develop too. That said, the Super Smash Bros. Series is one massive crossover at heart.
Does that mean
create something more? A way to enjoy characters other than fighters from a variety of video game worlds. Here's what we came up with. They're called Spirits.
Spirits!
And I don't mean the spooky kind.
Of course, it's that.
Spirit characters will lend a helping hand to your fighters, powering them up in battle.
What? So this is the secret mode.
Series, the characters are toys in the real world, but they are fighters in the world of the
imagination. Yeah, from the original Smash.
Returning to the real world is an ongoing theme. In the imagination, you can battle impossible combinations of characters. In this mysterious world, the unspeakable happens. Many beloved characters lose their physical forms.
What?
Except the fighters are turned into spirits, unable to return to the real world.
Huh?
The spirit. Fighters can join forces with spirits to enhance their powers.
What?
There's a massive amount of wildly different spirits. There are several classes of spirits. Standard spirits are dubbed novices. Stronger ones have the title advanced. Especially strong ones are called aces.
Okay.
Some are in a league of their own, legend.
Primary spirits.
One primary spirit can be assigned at a time. A primary spirit's power will be added to the fighter who has it equipped.
So this is like equipping. Yeah, this is like that. This is something similar from what Smash 4 had. If you have like customized of that.
While primary spirits enhance fighter stats, support.
So literally, you can be either getting stronger. You can like have auto like automatic magic that will just happen automatically and all that. Huh.
You'll find a variety of spirits lined up on the spirit board. Choose the one you want to battle.
Ooh.
When you do, you'll face off against a fighter whose abilities and personality are kinda sorta similar to the spirit. In the case of the Lakitu and Spiny spirit, you'll battle against Iggy Koopa and a group of small.
So trophies are not there anymore. So no longer we're having trophies and we're replaced by spirits. Okay. Let's see. So King DDD with a Gordo. A Gordo of a volley of Gordos appear from nowhere. Okay. Gutsman with Mega Man. Your oversized opponent shows off his throwing skill. Ooh. I went from Fire Emblem. Time to get at every opportunity. Killing Edge in hand. Hmm. The Imprison. Oh my goodness. He looks dark. Oh my god, Limp. Yo! We get a costume of Limp? Able Sisters? Oh my god, that's... That makes so much sense. Bullet Bill with Captain Falcon?
Hit the puppet fighter to acquire the spirit within.
Oh, so you acquire the spirit within as a reward. Oh.
You accidentally hit the shield. The damage will carry over. So you'll have an advantage the next time you encounter that spirit.
Oh, interesting.
Have strength based on their type.
Attack, grab, and shield.
Grab is strong against shield, and shield is strong against attack. It's important to
This is a balance between the customized stuff you get from Smash 4. Like, you customize your fighters with that... with your own preset of those abilities. Yeah, this is literally Smash 4 again of the customized fighters.
On your side, there are all kinds of things you can do. When you fight with a primary spirit equipped, it'll level up after battle.
Okay.
Or you can feed it snacks.
Ooh.
Some spirits even have an enhanced form you can only unlock by leveling them up.
Ooh!
You can also send spirits back to the real world. While you do have to say goodbye to that particular spirit, its core will stay. And, by combining these cores, you can summon a new spirit.
So this is going to be a lot of hours to grind.
You can also train spirits at dojos and the gym.
Okay.
Send them off in search of treasure, which they'll bring back to you. These seem like unlikely teams of characters, but each team could be somebody's dream come true.
That's going to be a lot of hours to grind and 100 complete.
While playing other modes or after turning off the game. So if you send out your spirits, just let them do.
So you can grind treasure during play or while it's off? Oh, that's nice.
Are known as masters. You can beat them to unlock facilities. Spirits can also be used to power up amiibo figure players.
Yeah, this is literally customized fighters. Repeat the process multiple times.
It's one great big collection of characters from many different series, but just how many would you guess there are?
There's a lot. Final Smash Meter?
Whenever you fight against the spirit, the Final Smash Meter is enabled. Some spirits even help you fill up your gauge at a faster rate.
Oh my god, Yoshi's Final Smash. No way. Oh my god, that's such a Melee. That's so inspired from Melee intro. Oh my god.
You can enjoy many unbelievable combinations and situations. The power of enemy and ally spirit teams is displayed here. Of course, stronger spirit teams make it easier to defeat weaker spirits.
Huh.
The more your power overshadows theirs, the less you'll be rewarded. It pays to have a fair fight. While assembling a team, press the Y button for a recommendation that has a type advantage against
the spirit.
The game will recommend support spirits who can help out with certain conditions. Keep that in mind.
Okay.
You can also fight against other players who are using spirits.
Wait, so you can battle people online with these?
Even the way spirit types interact in battle, think carefully when building your team.
Or local battle.
Balance your strengths in a 2-on-2 battle.
Wireless, local wireless and online play. That's what we were thinking about.
Wireless, or take the fight to the world with online play. To connect to Nintendo Switch consoles, press the ZR button to pull up the dashboard and select local wireless.
Okay.
There's no longer.
I hope online is good.
For fun and for glory.
No need for fun and for glory. Okay.
Based on three factors.
Preferred rules.
For online battles, you can set your preferred rules.
Yes.
These rules can be pre-registered.
Yes.
Before battle, one player's preferred rules will be chosen at random, and all players will fight using those rules. You can also choose not to set any preferred rules and let
yes.
the fight instead. If possible, the matchmaking system will find players with similar preferences and link them.
That's so good. Global Smash Power.
Global Smash Power is being factored into
match. Yeah, this is returning from online leaderboard. This is being back from Smash 4.
GSP score, such as 100,000, means you've got more points than 99,999 other players. Your GSP will change as the total population of players increases or you're overtaken.
My god.
Challenge, try increasing your global Smash power so that you'll naturally end up with some more serious opponents. By the way, you can set a GSP score for each fighter. Fighters you haven't used yet will be assigned a placeholder GSP based on the highest score you've set with one of the other fighters. If you repeatedly self-destruct on purpose, you could face a penalty, like being disconnected, so please don't do that.
Oh, yeah.
As with any multiplayer game, a stable connection is very important. For this reason, the matchmaking system will prioritize shorter distances between players. So even if you set your preferred rules, please understand that we can't promise you'll always be matched accordingly. As such, we'd appreciate it if you could make your connection as stable as possible. A wired LAN cable is recommended.
Yep.
We've prepared a variety of other features for local wireless and online battles.
Elite battles.
Once your global Smash power is high enough, you can enter elite battles. When you reach this level, feel free to pat yourself on the back. You're good, period.
After the so this is literally full glory.
And the team will definitely pay attention to the results of these elite battles. Everyone who plays online needs their own Smash tag.
Yep. This is since
if
Brawl.
You're a fellow player, you'll receive their Smash tag. But it's not like you'll lose your Smash tag even if you lose a battle. You simply gain more tags as you win. Try to collect lots of smash tags.
Short messages?
You can select short messages and send them before and after battles using the directional buttons.
Ah!
From a wide selection of varied preset messages.
Sadly, you can't customize it.
After you've chosen a fighter, you can enjoy other modes while you wait for the battle to begin. Not every mode will be available while matchmaking runs in the background, but you can leave and enter some game modes.
Okay. Spectator mode, yep.
Spectator mode returns once again, so you can watch other players' battles. Maybe you can pick up some.
But can you do it on friends? On friends?
Form a two-player team and play together online with a single Nintendo Switch system. You'll be paired up against two-player teams with the same setup.
Okay. Battle arena.
When you want to play online, you can create a special type of room to fight other players.
Okay.
If you set the rules for one of these battle arenas, you can fight against your.
Yeah, this is literally like ARMS.
Here, there are spots where you can join the
like ARMS match lobby. Yeah, this is literally
place your token.
That's literally good.
When you're in a battle arena, this should come in handy.
No.
With the Nintendo Switch Online app.
No.
With others in battle.
No.
It may become an essential tool for some players.
Talk to people on Discord.
We are also developing a free service for Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, and we're naming it Smash World.
Okay.
Instead of focusing on stats like win-loss records, we're allowing players to post gameplay videos, watch them, and more. Once the service starts, we'll offer regular updates so you can post to
okay.
content. Next, I'd like to change topics and talk a little about the system.
No! No!
Come from which games?
No! Oh, Fatal Frame? Ooh. Yeah, you guys are not getting it. You guys are not getting it.
Here I go.
Sorry for Isaac fans. Thwomp! Yep, they're spring mad. Yeah, that makes sense. I'm so disappointed Shadow has to be in the... Please forgive me! Oh, wait. Yes, please forgive me!
This might get
Ooh! Yo! Oh, that is so cool! Yo! Guile, really? Oh, wow, they got Akira in. Nice, Virtual Fighter. Don't tell me we get a Tekken character. Oh, please.
The total number of assist trophies is now 59. Actually,
59. Holy.
Assist trophies who can be KO'd can also be defeated by the fighter who summoned them just before they're KO'd. That way, you won't lose a point to the other player.
Okay. What's the other features?
Now, I'd like to cover a variety of other features in the game.
Help. Nah.
The controls or game modes,
it's good for people who are getting into Smash, which is good.
There are all kinds of helpful guides to check out.
Century Smash.
Century Smash may look familiar to veterans. It feels great to keep smashing enemies off the
screen. Wait a minute! Oh, this is Multi-Man!
And you can choose the music.
It's Multi-Man Smash! Oh my god!
In previous games, you had to unlock every fighter before playing All-Star mode, but now you can play it right out of the box.
Yes!
Available fighters will appear endlessly.
Yes! Replay, yes!
You can save the replay data of your battles.
Oh, you can convert it to video as well?
And now, you can create videos with it. There's also a menu where you can read those quick tips and tricks you see during loading screens. When viewing them, you can sort by category or fighter.
Alright, what's the challenges?
Complete challenges to earn rewards. This time, each page is sorted by the layout looks more like...
Oh, that's so clean!
Press the button to check out each picture.
That's so clean!
The records menu tracks your battle history. There are 5 different options.
Yes.
You can view battle data separately for offline and online play.
Yes.
Trade in smash tags to score some in-game gold.
Yep, we'll get a shop.
Exchange for music tracks, spirits, and items for spirits.
Yes.
If you're collecting music, I recommend visiting the shop to find the ones you want, instead of just relying on challenges.
What's the options?
You can enter the options menu by pressing the ZR button to open the dashboard.
Oh!
This one game supports 11 languages.
11 languages!
Very important to some of you. For example, the voices of Pokemon are different in several languages.
What's in
the
Japanese?
Are also specific to
oh.
Language.
Ooh.
Aldeano. Bevona. Abitante.
Okay.
These options were highly requested and well worth the effort.
Bow to me?
TV mode and handheld mode have separate settings for brightness and sound. They'll change automatically when you dock and undock, so be sure to set both.
Okay.
We've implemented a radar that displays the locations of all fighters.
You
can change its settings, including size. While it's limited.
Oh, so you can turn off either smaller or larger of that.
So you don't get distracted.
Okay. Custom balance.
If you're fighting against a friend on the same
side, oh yes,
your fighters. Sometimes a player is just too good. Try using this feature. When custom balance is adjusted, a symbol will be displayed. This feature is not available during wireless and online battles.
Good.
You can customize your Mii fighters and change their outfits.
Yes.
In addition to the voice options, there are a variety of outfits to choose from.
Yes. Oh my yes.
Speaking of Mii fighters, let me introduce you to some new outfits we added in.
I want to see. Let's see. Ooh. That's one Breath of the Wild. But nice. Splatoon set. Nice. Ribbon Girl. Okay. That looks a really good costume of Ribbon Girl. Chibi Robo. Ooh. Which is pretty interesting. Like, most of the... Oh, my God. They had to make a Nintendo Labo outfit. Like, literally? Okay.
Anyway, there's something I should point out.
What do you need to point out?
We've revealed all of the fighters you can find in the game.
Okay, DLC.
But there are even more coming post-launch.
What's DLC? What's the DLC?
While we've already implemented a huge roster of fighters, this is the Super Smash Bros. Series, which means we're leaving the opportunity open to add in more fighters as paid DLC. Since we already included every fighter from the past games, that means there are no more fighters to include unless we develop new fighters from scratch.
Yep.
And we're not talking about Echo fighters.
Yep. New characters in Scratch.
That will include one fighter,
one stage,
and multiple music tracks.
And multiple state music tracks. Okay.
To be $5.99.
Yes.
At the same time, we will offer the Fighters Pass.
I will actually get that.
Five fighters, five stages, and all of their music tracks. When creating something like the Fighters Pass.
So the deadline is February 2020. Okay.
Before it becomes available for purchase. However, please allow us to offer this pass before we're ready to reveal its contents. I hope only those who are confident in its value will purchase it. Again, the price is $24.99 for
yes!
all five sets. Now that we've finally confirmed the development of this DLC, please know that we'll be working really hard on it.
Oh.
I wonder if I'll ever get to take a break. By the way, here's one purchase bonus you'll get with the Fighter's Pass.
What do we get? Oh!
It's a Mii Sword Fighter outfit based on Rex from Xenoblade.
Yeah, that's what I call. Yeah.
When we started planning, so we couldn't add characters.
Yeah, I knew Rex would not make to the roster. Yeah. I agree.
We're also including some music from the Xenoblade Chronicles series. Give it a listen at Gower Plains sometime. Other Xenoblade Chronicles characters will also appear as spirits.
Yep.
We've yet to create any of the paid DLC, and we haven't locked down any release dates. But we'll start working on them as soon as we're finished with the main game. It may take around a year or so to finish releasing all the DLC. But on a separate note...
What's a limited time offer?
We're currently developing something. Something you'll get for
free. A limited time offer?
If you buy the Super Smash Bros. Ultimate game now. It isn't finished yet, but I want to give you a special sneak peek.
What is it? Why the dizzy? What? What? Wait a minute. Why is Mario... What? Huh? Why is there a piranha plant? What? Hello? Huh? What? What? Oh my God. Oh, Petey Piranha. So wait a minute.
That's right. Piranha Plant will take
what?
Brothers Ultimate, and not as an assist trophy, but as an actual fighter.
Huh?
It can spit poison, fire off spiky balls, and perform long-range attacks.
This as a free limited-time offer.
Its final smash is Petey Piranha. If you get caught in the cage, well,
what?
Piranha Plant is scheduled for completion after the launch of Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. We've gotten a little head start on it, but it probably won't be ready until a couple of months after launch. Please stay tuned. Remember,
Piranha Plant is a free, limited-time offer. For the physical version of the game, you only need to go through the My Nintendo Gold Point registration process to receive it. I hope you'll consider
pre-ordering.
We're also creating an amiibo.
Oh my god!
Later today, you'll be able to pre-purchase the game after finishing this Nintendo Direct. I hope you'll go to Nintendo.
I already pre-ordered it.
Before you forget.
You could earn double gold points of it? Oh.
I have an announcement for everyone watching this in North America.
Okay.
On our official site, you can find information for a variety of upcoming hands-on events. Participants will have a chance to try out all 74 fighters, so please check out the website to find out where we'll show up next, and more.
Alright. Alright. But seriously, PD Piranha?
Nintendo Direct for Super Smash
and
Ultimate.
Piranha Plant?
But before we go,
wait.
I should mention that the adventure mode of the game is nothing like what we came up with for the Subspace Emissary. That said, what exactly caused all these characters to leave their bodies and transform into spirits? I'll show you how it all begins and leave the rest to your imagination. Okay then, please look forward to the game's release.
Bye!
Don't let a single one get away!
What? Is this a cutscene? Is this a sequel? What's with the Master Hands? Oh no 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 no.
Stow your fear. It's now or never.
We'll win this. I know we will.
I love how it's voice acted. What? What? Oh shit! What even happening right now? What do you mean? What are we getting blasted about? Oh god! Bye, Palutena! Bye, Pit and Patu. Bye, Snake. Bye, everybody. Kirby, no! Kirby, fly. Kirby, fly. What? What? Wait, why is the whole universe? What is going on? What is going on? What? Oh, the song. Yo. What? Wait a minute, what? Whoa. Oh my god. So they turn to evil?
Everyone caught in the struggle.
So it's up to Kirby to revive the Elder Smashers and the other spirits. Oh my god. This song, y'all! No way! World of Light. Huh. Interesting. And that's it. That's literally it. Holy shit. Holy fuck. That's a 10 out of 10 right there. Oh my god. I can't wait for next month. Oh. Which I'll be back into Subspace Emissary by hopefully next week. Next week after this is uploaded. So be sure to watch this channel as soon as possible. Because this deadline is right about that to the tree. Just showing the treehouse, of course. Before the Smash Ultimate release. So be sure to check out my channel as soon as possible. And I'm going to be coming back into Subspace Emissary once again. So yeah. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys later. Bye.